Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, I want to discuss on creating a lambda function and associating the function with Cloudfront in AWS. The required permissions should be configured. I was getting some issues related to permissions, so let me show the demo. I have a Cloudfront distribution already configured. So let me show that, yeah. So and enabled with CNAME record for this test.albansblog.com. And this is the domain name. I want to register a lambda function to request the basic authentication while accessing the website, this specific website, test.albansblog.com. Right now, if I access this test.blog.com, it won't request for any authentication, but I want to enable the lambda function so that it will request for anybody access this website, it will request for a basic authentication. Let me now create a lambda function. So I will go into services, lambda, so create function, yeah, like I'm going with author from scratch, then like I'm going to give some function name here, so I'm going to give something like viewer request handler, new, then the runtime, you can go with Python or any required runtime. I'm going with node.js, but node.js 12.x version is not supported for lambda edge function. So we should be going with node.js 10x. So yes, select the version. So here this permission. So there is different execution roles. Create a new role with basic lambda permission. You can use an existing role. Or create a new role from AWS policy templates. I'm going with create a new role with basic lambda permissions. Create this function. Okay, the function is created. Now, if you come down here, you can see a editor. So with the index.js created. So in the index.js, I am going and adding some code. This will request the basic authentication if the user is not authenticated already. So it's a very simple script. I am just hard coding some username and password, then just validating with that in the request. If this is missing, I am just requesting the authentication. So I need to create a config.js because I am importing here. That will have the username credentials. So new file config.js. Okay, I am just keeping some auth username and auth password. Yeah, this is fine. Now, yeah, so here if you see here, it's coming like execution role. It's going to create this execution role, new role. Other than that, things are fine. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a trigger. So because I want to, this lambda function should be invoked from the CloudFront. So I'm going and selecting this trigger, CloudFront. Now, okay. Yeah, before that we should be saving this function. So one second, let me first save this. Okay, now go and add trigger here, CloudFront. Okay, click on this deploy to lambda at edge. Yeah, here you have to select this distribution. My case, only one distribution is by default selected. Then cache behavior, I can leave it. Now here the CloudFront event type you need to select. There is a multiple option, origin request, then origin response, then viewer request and viewer request. Means viewer request is like when the request comes from the browser, this specific function will get executed. Viewer response means like whenever CloudFront sends a response back to browser. So origin request is whenever CloudFront send a backend request. Then origin response is whenever we get the response from the backend. So my case, I am sending the viewer request because whenever the browser send the request, the script will check whether the user is already having the authentication token. If not, it will send the it will request for the authentication. Now, yeah, click on confirm, deploy to lambda-edge. So click on deploy. Yeah, so I'm getting this error. So this was I was referring as the permission error. Your function's execution role must be assumable by the edge lambda.amazon.aws.com service principal. So this is some issue with the permission. So the whatever the permissions we already associated for this one, because we created a new permission, that permission should be having assumable, that execution role assumable for this edge lambda.amazon.aws.com. So for that, what you can do is you can go to this IAM screen. Let me first cancel this. I will go to IAM first. Yeah, if you go to the roles, here if you see, there is a role created with a name, viewer request handler. This is the Lambda function name. So click on that. If you go to the trust relationships, here you can see the trust relationship. If you see here, already there is a assumable STS action equal to STS assumable is having a service with name lambda.amazon.com. So what we need to do is we need to add that edge lambda also, because we are going to deploy to the edge server. So lambda edge, so it's array, then you just put that edge lambda.amazon.aws.com. okay, that's fine. Now just update this trust policy. Yeah, this is fine. Now go back now again to the lambda. Okay, go and edit this. Okay, yeah, now go and add the trigger again. Select the CloudFront, deploy to lambda to edge. Yeah, here the viewer request, then acknowledge this and deploy. Yeah, now the deployment will happen. Yeah, successfully created version one of your application. It means it's deployed. Now if you go back to this CloudFront distribution, click on this, go to behaviors, edit it. If you come down, you can see this is associated. So CloudFront event, viewer request, lambda function, this is the ARN for the function. Yeah, so now let us go and access this page again. Yeah, it's asking the basic authentication, and I given some username, so I can enter that. If you think there is some test user, yeah, so if you enter the right correct password, it will allow you to access the page. So that is configured in this lambda function. If I go back to this, okay, here I am keeping this some sample username and password, then I am comparing that whether I am getting the same username password in the authorization header. So otherwise I am sending the response back saying is 401 and unauthorized. This is for just for a sample. I took this scenario, so you can modify the response headers or response body. So whatever the operations you want to perform, you will be able to perform it. Okay, here only thing to note is the permission. So we need to edit the default permission. Otherwise, even you can create a new IAM role same way. So one more thing to note is maybe let me go to the IAM. Yeah. Roles. Yeah, this is the this is created by the system. But you can even create a custom role, then you can provide the required permissions. If you see here the permissions tag, the by default, if I go to this policy is added, if I go to the policy, it's having only CloudWatch log related permissions. But if your lambda functions doing any specific functions or connecting to S3 or any other functions, So we should be adding the required policies. So that's the one thing in the permission tab. Another one is the trust relationship. We need to ensure like this edge lambda.amazon.aws.com is added. Okay, thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.